परित्राणाय साधुनां विनाशाय चतुष्कृतां धर्म संस्थापनार्थाय संभवामि युगे युगे. Even Lord Krishna said that for the establishment of law and dharma, both the protection of innocence and elimination of miscreants are equally warranted. Honorable Chairman, esteemed jury, and my dear learned co-participants, this is DEVESH Tripathi, Assistant Commanding CISF, speaking for the motion, and I vehemently claim that legal and institutional framework for human rights are adequately balanced and fairly strengthened. I would further claim that any sentimental inclination towards additional reinforcement of human rights will jeopardize the national security and developmental process of the nation. Honorable Chief Justice Deepak Mishra, in famous Aadhaar judgment on 26 September 2018, categorically stated that even fundamental rights are not absolute but are provisional and therefore can be restricted and qualified in state matters of absolute necessity. Therefore, the adequacy of the present human rights framework cannot be underestimated merely because it provides for exceptional derogation or reasonable scope of restrictions. In constitutional scheme and legal framework, sufficient provisions are in place for protection of human rights and respect for human dignity. Fundamental rights provided in Part 3 of the Constitution provides for several legal rights which are reflections of the International Bill of Human Rights, such as UDHR, ICCPR and ICCR. Several other legal rights are provided in CRPC which provide for in matters of legal and criminal justice system. Laws such as RTIR, Right to Education Act, Human Rights Protection Act, Food Security Act and MNREGA provide additional sanctity and respect for human rights. Honorable Chairman, even institutional framework for human rights protection are adequately balanced and fairly supportive. Supreme Court and High Courts under Article 32 and 226 have been given immense powers. The Menaka Gandhi petitions, D.K. Basu guidelines, Menaka Gandhi petitions and other such cases provide for the independence of judiciary. International jurist Hugo Grotius says that countries have been given certain rights and responsibilities to perform sovereign functions, and international covenants such as ICCPR and 4 Geneva Convention give legitimate scope of incurring collateral damage on the basis of necessity and proportionality and even suspending human rights in national exigencies. The grey area of debate is those extraordinary exigencies when certain rights of individuals become subservient to national interests and stern actions are warranted. It is in this spirit that Honorable Justice Umanath Singh, speaking for full bench of Meghalaya High Court on 3rd November 2015, categorically and specifically asked the central government to implement AFSPA in certain militancy at Garhwals of Meghalaya to restore peace and rule of law. In 2018, World Economic Forum quantified the effects of terrorism over economic growth of the countries and reported that GDP of India suffered a setback of 0.91% in 2004, further escalating to more than 2% in 2018. As per NCRC, civilian casualties suffered due to terrorist and Naxal-related attacks rose from 2,597 in 2004 to a staggering 5,512 in 2018. Isn't it a matter of national security to ensure a halt to this mass massacre of innocent civilians, or should we still be talking about utopian idealism of human rights? But the paradoxical situation is that while there is increasing and widespread concern for the observance of human rights by security forces operating in most gruesome environment, gross violations of the same by militant organization goes unabated. The countermeasures by the security forces are often restrained when the militants bring into local population, making it impossible to attack their base without collateral damage. We are expected to be miraculous doctor who has to cure tumor, but without using a scalpel and without causing pain. Damned if we do, damned if we don't. But on a lighter note, if given a chance, my worthy opponents, my worthy crusaders of human rights will come here and will heartfully cry that security forces failed to protect that poor kid from Bangalore who wished to migrate to Syria for the noble cause of joining that auspicious organization named the Islamic State. Or those noble missionaries such as Burhan Wani and Dujana who were killed, depriving us of their immense talent and potential of becoming Hafiz Saeed and Masood Azhar of future. Sun Tzu says in his Art of War that there cannot be a good war or a bad peace. Honorable Justice Madan Lokur of Supreme Court in counter-association case of 2016 categorically stated that national security is of paramount importance and proportionate retaliation in security force operation is legally justified with impunity, and here I stand. And here I stand to answer my worthy opponents who cry for Afzal Guru because national security provides them that luxury under the blanket of freedom that we provide, and they don't even light a candle when 10 Maoists killed 10 CRPF Jawan in an ambush and brutally cut open the stomach of one of them to stuff a bomb inside his bleeding intestine. At the end, I'll exclaim with pride and honor that my wife, my family and of all those in uniform know it very well that our death in preserving human rights is a necessary concomitant of our duties so that the nation sleeps peacefully and debates conveniently.